Welcome to the Climax Academy Live. I'm Jim Miller, the Global Training Manager. Today we're going to be addressing some top five frequently asked questions on the BB5000, which I'm standing behind here. If you have any questions during this presentation, please go to the bottom of your screen to the Zoom Q&A and type those in. As always, I like to talk about safety first. Be careful about any kind of pinch hazards, chip hazards. Look around our area, make sure there's nothing that we're going to trip on. We're not going to be running a machine today, so I don't need to go into too much detail about that risk assessment, but I just want to remind everybody to make sure you do that. So once we're comfortable with our area, we'll go ahead and we'll start I have five questions that I generally get the most of. And then while I'm presenting that, if you have any other further questions, there'll be time at the end to do that. So let's go ahead and start with that. Our first question that we get a lot of people asking is, what's the minimum number of bearings that I have to have? So anytime I have a bore that I need to, and as long as it's a through bore, I have to have at least two bearings. That's the minimum number of bearings that I have to have, because I have to establish a datum or an inline. I have to be able to support the bar in two places to be able to maintain a datum. So generally, if I have one bore that is through, I can put a bearing on either side. Now, if I have to, if I don't have a through bore, I have a blind bore, then I can put two bearings on one side of that bore and extend the bar out and the tool head out or the tool bit in the bar out beyond that. And we call that a cantilever setup, when I have two bearings on one side and then I'm boring at the other side. Now, that being said, one bearing on either side, two bearings on one side, or in some cases I can use an ID bearing, but I can't really bore up to that. I can bore up to it, but I can't bore beyond an ID bearing. So those are the scenarios that I can use, but I've always got to have a minimum of two bearings. Okay, so the next question that we get a lot is how far apart can I get away with unsupported? So what's the minimum distance that I can have between those bearings? And I always use the rule of thumb that 7 times the diameter of the bar is a good number. So whatever my bar diameter is, whether it's 1¼ inches, 1¾ inches, 2¼, 3½, I mean, any diameter of bar, I can times that by 7. And that's the number that I should not exceed from my bearing to my tool bit. So if I have two bearings, then I can double that number. But if I'm cantilevered, then that's my number. I can only go 7 times the diameter of the bar away from that bearing. Otherwise, I'm starting to get a lot of flexibility. All metal bends, right? So the farther I am from my support, the more flexible my bar becomes, and that's just the nature of metal. It's gonna deflect the farther away from a bearing it becomes. So that's a good rule of thumb. Yes, I can go farther than that, and I can go less than that, but that's kind of a good rule that I use, that I can pretty much maintain a good depth of cut and a good feed rate with that number. So, okay, question number 3. How do I know how fast to turn my bar? So what I use is a formula called surface feet per minute. And what that is, it's a combination of RPM based on the diameter that I'm boring. So one real easy calculation is RPM equals surface feet per minute times 4 divided by the diameter. So, that's how I calculate the RPM based on the surface feet per minute is how much ground the tool bit is covering. And so, and we'll talk about that in a little bit here in the next question. So that's the formula I use. RPM equals surface feet per minute times 4 divided by the diameter. Now, there's another algebraic formula that I've been taught and that I use that allows me to calculate what my surface feet is or what my RPM needs to be. So that formula is surface feet per minute times 12 equals pi, which is 3.1416, times the diameter that I'm boring times the RPM. So anytime I'm using an algebraic formula, I have to keep both sides equal. So if I know my surface feet, I times that by 12, and then I divide that by pi times the diameter times the RPM. If I don't know the RPM and I do know my surface feet, I can times my surface feet by 12, take that number, and then divide that by pi times the diameter, and that tells me what my RPM is. That's a little more complicated. So anyway, in either case, RPM varies based on the diameter of the bore, and that's how I calculate it. Okay, question 4. How do I know what type of tool bit to use? Good question. I mean, this is based on the multiple factors. What material type I have, what's the condition of the material, is it hard or is it soft? So, you know, how long is the bore and how abrasive is the bore is really what the two things that I need to determine how much my tool bit is going to wear. All tooling material will wear based on two things, heat and friction. So the faster I turn the tool bit and the longer it's turning that speed is what determines what's going to wear it down. So is the bore welded? How rigid is my setup? You know, all these things play a factor. So by calculating the proper surface feet for the tooling that I'm using really helps prolong the tool life. That's why it's important that I be able to calculate my surface feet per minute, and it's also kind of important that I select the proper feed rates to minimize that heat and friction. So hopefully that helps. So the last number 5, the one that I get a lot of is, how do I calculate machining time? So again, RPM is one of the things that I need to know, the revolutions per minute. So RPM times the feed rate, that's how much it advances per revolution, divided by the overall length. So let's put that in practical terms. Say I have a 5-inch bore and it's 6 inches long and I want to use high speed steel. So I run my numbers and I calculate that with high speed steel, I only want to turn about 100 surface feet. So the RPM for that diameter is about 75. So normally if I'm using a roughing feed calculation, I'll say 10 thousandths per revolution. So RPM times 10 thousandths equals 3/4 of an inch. So 6 inches divided by 3/4 is about 8 minutes. So this bore is gonna take me 8 minutes to cover from one end to the other. That's how I calculate that formula. So, okay, those are the 5 big questions that I have. So at this time, I'm gonna open it up for any other questions that we might have out there. Okay, so if there's no other questions, then we're gonna go ahead and end our session today. But if you have any other questions that you'd like to be answered or any other machines that you'd like us to address in the future, go ahead and submit those to askcpmt@cpmt.com, and we'll make sure we get those in one of our other videos. Thanks for joining, and have a great day.